Let's get some practice evaluating these logarithms by hand. Letter A, we want to know what's log base 4 of 64. I'll call this x. How we can do this is by turning it into the exponential form. Remember, this means the same exact thing as 4 to the power of x equals 64. That's rewriting the logarithmic form in exponential form. And what do we have now? We have an exponential equation. We know how to solve these. The technique is to rewrite both sides having the same base. And we can do that keeping the left side. We can rewrite 64 as 4 to the third power. 4 times 4 is 16, times 4 again would be 64. Now that these bases are equivalent, we can just set the exponents equal. This means x is 3, and that's what we were looking for in the first place. We called what we were looking for x. Let's do the exact same thing for these other equations. Let's just call letter B y. And so this logarithmic equation, we put it in exponential form. This means 3 to the y equals square root of 3. How can we rewrite both sides as base 3? Square root means 1/2 power. So we could just rewrite this as 3 to the y equals 3 to the 1/2. Both sides are base 3. We set the exponents equal to each other. Y must be 1/2. That's what we were looking for. We call the logarithm y. One more to go. Let's call this last one z. Log base 2 of 1/8 is z. Switch this to the exponential form. This means 2 to the z power equals 1 over 8, another exponential equation. Can we rewrite this as base 2? Well, 2 cubed is 8, but that would be 1 over 2 cubed. We want this to have base 2, not over base 2. The way we can rewrite a fraction as not a fraction is with negative exponents. This would mean the same thing. Think back to your properties of exponents as 2 to the negative 3 power. The 3 makes it the 8, the negative would make it 1 over 8. If we do this, the bases are once again equal. We can set the exponents equal. Z must be negative 3. That's some great practice evaluating these logarithms.